Hey Fit Fam, Carnell the Mad Dragon here for the first ever episode of Trial by Fire. And I was thinking to myself, who better than to kick things off than none other than Coach No Mercy himself, John Black. So I'm a little banged up, as you can see. So I was like, what you got for me? What are we gonna do?
Let's do total body. We're gonna start with this tire.
Okay. Please don't make me cry on camera.
That's why they call it No Mercy Training. Let's do this.
All right, Fit Fam, how's it going? So basically, just to give you a heads up, the exercise routine will be in the description of this video, so you can refer back to it to see what we did or whatnot. But starting off this exercise, oh my goodness, see, like John has me warming up with the tire, right? And I'm thinking to myself, I was not expecting this tire to be as heavy as it is, right? And so if you see my facial expression, I'm just like, oh wow, I'm gonna have to focus on this one. Definitely using two hands. All right, nice and easy. But you know, like I'm getting it in. But then all of a sudden, John wants to increase the difficulty level. Take it up a notch. Ask me if I'm like, hey, all right, try with one hand. I'm like, Okay. Try my hand at it. Focusing. And I'm like, no. Not happening. Tried it on the other hand. I was basically feeling like, oh no. Like, I cannot lift this higher because I am not worthy. Not at all this day. So we moved on to, on this one, the chest press. Now, with this routine, just to give you a heads up, if you haven't seen it in the description or whatnot, you are doing upper and lower, giving yourself time to rest in between. So once you're working upper, you're giving your legs time to rest. Once you're working lower, you're giving your upper body time to rest. So doing the chest press, this is actually the hammer strength equipment, which is really good. I really enjoyed this piece of equipment, because normally I use the hammer strength equipment that you're sitting upright. And so with this one and it's flat bench, I honestly did not think I was going to be able to move this weight with the four plates on each end. And I was just like, oh snap, I got it. Boom. And so like, I got another one in me. Let's get it. So knocked out another one and I was feeling pretty proud of myself on that one. Love this equipment. I gotta get back on it, but it's not in every gym though. So Hinge gyms in the gym. Yeah. So moving on to legs, get that leg press, good piece of equipment, working out the legs. So again, in this routine, we're steadily going up with each plate. We started out with the 45s. On legs, we started just a little bit heavier than upper body, obviously. So trying to, I wouldn't say max out on this, but definitely get it in, increasing that weight. John did have me, if you notice the hand positioning, this is a good technique for is knowing your distance. If you're not trying to go too deep, but go low enough to where you're just like, all right, this is where you need to be. So cross your arms, have your elbows extended out, and letting your elbows meet your knees, and back and forth on that one. I think I'm actually trying to cover up my face so you don't see the pain and disgust. So back to upper on this one, working back. I've done this before. I've been on this equipment, so not anything new to me, but definitely familiar with this one going in. But also take note to our hand positioning on this one. As we are going up in weight, we are switching the hand positioning as far as going like wide, we're going center, going inner. So if you notice that our hands are in different places, that is on purpose. Got that good back shot, trying to show a little something. I'm in there. I'm trying to keep up with John, doing the best I can. It's like my muscles are looking like show muscles right now. It's like, man, I need them go muscles. Like, when you gotta get up and go, do your thing, push that weight whenever, wherever, when the situation hits you, you need to know if you can do it. And John's facial expression kills me every time. It does seem like he's growling, like he's a lion, like Mufasa. And in my facial expression, it's looking like. But, you know, hey, leave it all out on the table. I'm like, I'm going in. Doing the hand positioning on this one, I did say earlier that I was pretty banged up. So he had me do a reverse grip on the pull downs, focusing, getting it in. Definitely keep your elbows tight to the body, letting your biceps do all the work. Boom, boom. Now we're on leg curls, getting it in. Them hamstrings are no joke. Always remember proper form. John was telling me earlier when we were doing this, he had a little mishap. It might have been that he didn't warm up during that time, which I've been there too. When you just want to get it in, you've known that you can lift this weight, but at this point in time, you're not warmed up, and any slight could end it right then and there. Like, oh, that was an early workout. So remember the stretch, remember the warm up, good stuff. Pull-ups, different positioning on this one. This one is a bit more advanced, bringing your chest to the bar. Yeah, that's, hey, you gotta know your levels. Switching to calf extensions. Get them calves in. Neglected muscles from time to time. And like, when you think you're just doing quads, it's not all about the quads, the hamstrings, the quad, the front quads, you know, and your calves. You gotta get your calf work in. If you're really trying to be aesthetic, you really have to be conscious of that. Moving on, we got the delt action going. Military press with dumbbells. Focus, always focus. Might not always be fun in games, but maintain proper form. Now this is the end. This is the end of our workout. During this time, you're using some of the legs, but this is the ab workout where you're incorporating the legs as well as upper body, but focusing on the abs at the very end. This could be at the very end, or it could be in the center of the workout, middle, whatnot. But yeah, we got it in. So, this is the end of the workout. I think I did okay.
You did great. Just another day at the No Mercy Workshop. Again, another one bites the dust.
See us next time for episode 2, and I try to do my thing or whatnot, but till next time. Click the like button. Any comments or concerns, express it in the comments section. Any updates, I am on social media. Just Google Carnell Holly. I pop up.